Gene and Steve Show. Step aside and let the big kids play. Raw Dog in your ears. Weekdays.
Where's that email list? Where's the email list? Give me the email list.
I'm not giving it to you yet. Let kids come to the party.
Give me the email list. Give me the email list. Give me the email list. I'm going to come around there and get it.
Oh, okay.
It's
no,
not the accurate one. I don't even have...
Whenever he's on a rant or on a Warpath rant, we need like an Old West like song. Just like...
Gunslingers. Wah, wah, wah. Good point.
Give me the email list.
No.
Just give me the list.
Wait until after the party.
Give me
done.
The list.
No. Listen, because we don't know what other parents are actually coming, but they just haven't emailed because, you know, they haven't. So, no, you can have it afterwards, but even that, I'm just like,
give me the list.
No.
I'm going to start randomly saying kids' names on the air so we can identify which parents they are.
And what? They're listening right now? Because I'm pretty sure they're not listening.
Oh, no.
It's probably nearly their bedtime.
I want the email list.
No.
I want the fucking email list. This is not difficult. Just hand me the email list. By the way, hello to my son, who I know is actually listening today.
Hola, hey, Callum.
No, not you. The proper one.
Patron.
Yeah. All right, so I don't understand. It's a Friday night. My 8-year-old daughter is having a party on Friday night between 7 and 9. You know, and in the evening.
You know, after they've been at school all day, being totally fucking pumped up because there's a party tonight.
So she invited 12 kids. She only wants to invite girls. I told her, don't invite... just girls. You'll regret it.
I know.
But she wanted to just invite girls.
Yeah.
There was one girl she didn't want to invite. She is coming 100%. All the others, this is what we're getting. Oh, well, that's kind of past her bedtime.
Hey, Ginkgo.
7 o'clock. 7 o'clock on a Friday.
Fucking o'clock.
7-year-old. Pumped up, done school all week.
Oh, I... Mr. Helicopter just came over to me. He's like, I'm a helicopter parent.
Yeah, you are, but you're a cool one.
Dragon Eyes is asking what helicopter parents are.
He's
young, he has no kids.
Okay. Helicopter parents are basically parents that over-monitor your life. So, as an example, when you're perhaps, like, London's age... Okay, so, like... 8 years old.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You go to bed at a ridiculous fucking time, even on weekends. Like 7 o'clock, you're in bed by 7 o'clock. You can't go on the internet. You can't.
Yeah.
You can't use
that. They sabotage their own kids.
Yes, they do.
They do. Can't use computer.
Oh yeah, yeah. Actually, this is the easiest way to describe a helicopter kid. Ethan, would you please explain to me how you were raised with your dad? What could you do?
Would you like a tissue before you start crying?
Okay, let's go through. Let's go through TV first of all. What could you?
I couldn't watch SpongeBob, which was tragic.
Okay, there we go. And
that's not a childhood.
Ratings of movies up until you were 15.
Oh, he followed the PG-13. Can't watch it until you're 13.
Okay,
or can't watch it until you're 17, 18.
Whatever, okay,
whatever.
So he ran on that. Mm-hmm. So obviously movies. Going out. Places were you times you had to be back? Were you allowed to go out?
Sometimes.
Okay.
So it sucks.
Okay, so the problem I have here, mm-hmm, is
like being on a leash made out of a very poisonous snake.
Right.
Wow, that's
that's dark. It's good.
Dark.
I like that. It's actually.
I think some people like that one actually. Yeah. Ginkgo's like, wow, no hate there.
It's ridiculous.
And Dragon Eyes really like that reference.
Yeah, that's actually the best way to do it. So basically, what we've done is we've kind of arranged for an outside party for London. And basically, the backyard,
it's
we've like, actually got disco lights.
It's
and
a
we've
nighttime.
Got the
so
nighttime one.
It's all like a rave party. There's music. Everything is like in black light, glow light. Uh-huh. You know, we've got like black light twister on the floor. Uh-huh. You know, we're actually like spray painting the ground.
I mean, this is for 7-8-year-olds, okay? So there's not going to be like, you know, shots and things like that. But, you know, I mean, we've got glowing, we got like light up glasses and stuff
and
like that.
All kinds of cool stuff. It has to be outdoors.
Here's the problem I have with all the parents round here, and I'm saying all of them because it is right across the board round here. Now, bearing in mind, we live in a fishing community, right? These are people that go out and die while they're trying to catch fish. They're generally a harder breed of people. Mm-hmm. But I swear to God, the moment they have kids, they wrap them in fucking cotton wool round here. Oh, it's too late. Oh, they'd love to come if it was earlier. And I'm like, I am not fucking rearranging my kid because your kid is a pussy.
I don't think it's the kids because I don't think the kids are going, oh no, it's too late. I
don't
know.
Oh no, the kids
are. And you know, I think the thing is that the parents are going, oh, you know, yeah, she's just totally, you know, wrecked at nighttime after school. She's never going to be able to make
it.
She has to be in bed by then.
Helicopter parent
them. The other person is like, oh no, she needs her beauty sleep. She'll be, you know, she's really tired after school. What the fuck? I mean,
every parent,
come on.
Every parent that has given us the bullshit excuse that it's too late for them are getting an email from me.
7 o'clock on a Friday night.
At 3 a.m. Saturday morning. That's when I'm sending the email.
They won't get it until, like, you know, Monday or Tuesday.
No, I'm done. I'm really done. I'm at the point of my life where when I see bullshit going on,
yeah,
I got to call it. Because here's the thing, everyone, right? Is the reason these people exist is because we allowed them to exist. Mm-hmm. Because we were being polite.
Yeah, Ginkgo is just like, oh, you know, do a sleepover with, you know, tents in the yard. No, I wouldn't even want their kids here for that long. 2.5 hours is, like, good.
Well, it's not that. That wouldn't happen.
No, there's no way that would happen.
No, I mean, we honestly, London is the only one.
That's what I'm saying.
Who can actually go to someone's house and have a sleepover.
That's what I'm saying. I don't want to have to deal with kids crying because they want to go home at like 11, 12 o'clock.
Yeah.
Because that, you know.
And when we have had kids stay over here where the parents have tried it and the kids have bombed out. And I mean, I speak to the kids.
Yeah, Babylon is like, you know, they make their kids into pussies, front runners. You know, they don't let them face adversity at all. And it's
no, they
just,
don't.
You know, and I don't get it.
They absolutely, and that's the biggest problem. They have absolutely no coping skills at all.
Yeah. Hey, Marcia. Yeah, no, I'm, you know, these kids, he's like, oh, you can just show a movie, Paranormal Activity. Our daughter would love it. She, you know, it's one of her favorite movies, but, you know.
It's just getting out of hand. Mm-hmm. It's getting so out of hand now because you can't. When you're dealing with these parents, when you're dealing with them, they because as a society, we've basically come around to the idea that whoever has the most extremist views, right, is the default setting. So because a parent, well, no, I don't let them go on the internet. Oh, I don't let them watch these movies. I don't let them. Mm-hmm. That's the epitome of being a good parent now. And anybody that lets their kid watch, I don't know, you know, a film that parent doesn't approve of, then that other parent is a bad parent. And that's bullshit.
Yeah, Michael's saying, you know, his kid bumps into another kid and then he's the one that has to apologize.
Right.
You know? It's just, you know.
I still remember my dad told me when I was getting, you know, and all this bullying bullshit, I was getting bullied at school by a kid half my size when I was like 7 years old. My dad told me to lay him the fuck out. He goes, hit him so hard he doesn't get back up. You'll never have problems with him again.
Yeah.
And I did.
Yeah. Now, I just want to say a quick shout-out to the entire Chicago Fire Department that is watching us right now on Periscope. Hey.
All right, boys.
That's really cool. Somebody was saying, you know,
I can make endless jokes about hoses right now.
And poles. Mm-hmm. But yeah.
He actually broke his rib on a pole.
Yes, I did. He did. It was a fireman's pole as well, yeah!
You know, Babylon is saying, you know, the sheltered ones become the most curious, and somebody was like saying, you know, yes, they're going to be held back on everything, and then they're going to rebel. I mean, you know.
There was an
How
old...
did you feel with that, Ethan? You weren't exactly super rebellious, but you became...
No, but he was super stupid.
I really wasn't that stupid compared to Juliet.
Okay, we're not doing a comparison now, but
yeah, you were because you got caught.
But that was afterwards.
I know.
Okay, I really didn't get caught with.
Well, it's not illegal to give blowjobs in car parks, is it?
Well, it is when there's like a big age difference. she gets caught a lot more. Mm-hmm. For worse things, I got caught.
She's an idiot. Yeah.
For staying out an hour to midnight, not even to like 2 o'clock in the morning. I got caught staying out past 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
Sue me. I don't.
He did more than that. He just removed everything you owned. But your dad was weird because he'd punish you with food as well. Like he would. Withdraw all normal foods from you, and you'd have like some bullshit like green beans only for dinner.
Green beans and tomato soup. I told him I didn't like tomato soup, but I didn't mind it.
Yeah, that was a smart move.
Hayden Demi Papa and.
I'm still happy that the fire department is there.
That's cool, right?
You need to be putting out the fires here.
You know, Mason's just like, oh yeah, children have to feel the consequences of parental competition, and I think that's the problem. He's not being serious because he's
no.
You know, and I, you know, it's just.
It is just it's you know round. We are fucking lobster fishermen, firefighters of Chicago.
Yeah, Demi Papa just tuned in. He's actually asking what helicopter parents are. Maybe they don't have that terminology in the UK. I mean,
it's
do they?
Basically I don't know what they say in the UK now for this time. It's basically that parent that basically mummies their kids.
Yeah.
You know, they don't let them go to this, and they're always fucking wiping their noses, and they've always got fucking hand sanitizer
we're not
on them.
Like 2 and 3 year olds, we're talking about like when they're like 8 and mm-hmm. 10 and older than that. And you know, the ones that just don't let their kids be kids. Mm-hmm. You know, and you know, have to know where they are every 2 seconds. And,
but round here,
and that kind of stuff.
And here's how it works in Maine, right? Basically, Maine works on a bully system here. Right? Yeah. All parents work on a bully system. And I know
And the women are the bullies.
Yeah. Basically, the women here, no guy ever stands up to them. Every time I have basically called a woman out on her bullshit here, mm-hmm. she looks like she's going to shit a brick. Because you can tell no one's ever, ever stood up against her.
Yeah, G. Barnes is saying, you know, they hover over their kids.
Yeah.
You know?
It's helicopter parents or snowplow parents, I think some people snowplow call it, maybe.
Yeah.
Why would snowplow? I don't understand that reference. Mm-hmm.
You just, like, take over for your kids and just move,
you just move everything out of the way.
So
but it's not even that, because
yeah,
that doesn't really, that doesn't really, like, helicopter parenting doesn't really kick in until you're probably in your teens. But what's going on at the moment
Diggler,
is just this.
One of the Chicago Fire guys, he said, you know, I'm getting into jiu-jitsu, so mm-hmm. he's getting his kids into it, and they're never going to be bullied. And it's not the kids that are getting bullied, it's parents bullying other parents.
No, I was saying how, you know, I was, you know, nowadays, it's like, I'm saying nowadays, it's like if a kid's getting bullied, it's like, well, you got to go tell mm-hmm. a teacher, and let's all sit down and hold hands and sing Kumbaya. Yeah. That guy there, basically, if his kid gets bullied... Kid's gonna fucking lay the other kid out. Yeah. End of story. That's
then
how it's
you're
been
go,
done.
Have to go apologize to the other parent.
No, and that's the joke. His kid will get kicked out of school.
Yeah.
But no, fucking do that mm-hmm. because we as a society have gotta fucking get back to that.
Marcia says that her kid said that she helicopters her grandkid's mom. I don't understand the concept.
Right, that's too many by proxies.
Yeah.
There's a proxy chain going on there. I'm not even sure.
She helicopters her grandkids, I think.
Well, that's just spoiling, isn't it? Really. I mean, you're probably on about more spoiling, and that's different. Spoiling. I'm not on that's about that, because helicopter parents don't generally spoil their kids either. Mm-hmm. You certainly weren't spoiled, were you? Mm-hmm. Uh-uh.
You know, kids these days are making friends with people on the internet. You know,
no,
that's
they're not.
Different
thing. Are you on about it from a danger point of view?
No, no.
Oh,
I think
yeah.
That's just that's normal.
Yeah,
I think that's
exactly.
What they're saying, you know.
Mm-hmm. It's strange because it is. You can see there are kids here.
Steps back.
That. Whatever.
Keep going.
The thing I love about Steph's birthday is it being on September the 11th is that she's at, you know, whatever, fucking Applebee's, right? And they're all like, no, come and join our party. And it's like everybody else is fucking solemn. And there's a bunch of Texans in the corner fucking celebrating on September the 11th. It's just like, wow, they're fucking hardcore fucking Democrats there or something. I don't know what they'd be. Because I guess, yeah, I don't know. I don't know how that works.
Yeah. So. No, okay. Helicopter parents is not another name for Jehovah's Witnesses. But it's not. I don't think it's the same.
No,
I think they're just more
honestly,
like, protective. But
my experience,
yeah, everybody doesn't know what helicopter parents are. They're like from other places. So
okay,
this is like an American
helicopter parents, right? Are mollycoddling mm-hmm. parents. They're the ones that basically do everything for their kids. They don't let their kids ever interact with and deal with their own problems. So, you know, it's that kind of thing. I just, it's like...
Somebody's asking, but how do we stop them? You can't.
You can, right? And all of you, hello, Chicago Fire Department, that's so awesome! Yay,
they
fireman!
They said they're on downtime right now, so
all
they're,
right.
they're watching.
All right, so if I
would you like this on you? Would that make you feel better?
Okay. So if I call the Chicago area code and then do 911, could I speak to them?
I don't think that's exactly
it doesn't work
how
like
it
that.
Works.
Damn
no.
It. Okay.
No.
I'm not going to say that. where was I at? Okay, the way we stop them, you right. call parents on this bullshit. We all know helicopter parents. Gone are the days because we are fast entering a society where you can't say anything to anyone about them being offended. The only way to fight that is to do it. And if enough people do it...
Yes, yeah.
This is why I want the email list.
I'm not giving
just
you
give
the
me
email
it so I can
list.
Read it on air.
No.
I'll just read the first names. No. Just give me. Okay, I shouldn't have said it like that. Can I just have a look? Because no. maybe I can draw something from their names, which would be comedy element for the show.
Absolutely. No.
I'm not going to read out their name. I promise.
I'm not giving you the list.
I promise. I promise.
I'm not giving it to you.
I promise I won't. I promise I won't read out their names.
I know. Nev is just like, you know, let's stand up to, you know, parents that helicopter.
Yeah, seriously,
like
call them out on it. This is what's going to happen. And I'm not just saying this for the show's benefit. I'm honest to God. I'm done. Every parent that has sent a message to us saying, oh, well, it's too late. And, you know, that's too late for him to, you know, and any of this bullshit. I'm going to go, you need to stop being
I'm
a helicopter parent.
You can't make me give it to him.
That's fine. There's an open parents evening for her class. I'll do it then in front of everybody. I am tired of just sitting back and watching. Because here's the problem with helicopter parents, right? And these type of controlling parents. They work on the basis that nobody will stand up to them. Because what do? They bully their own kids, right?
Yeah,
so you know fully well.
Yeah, he doesn't have any shame at all. DB Papa's just like, Steve has no shame.
You're a helicopter car owner.
No, I'm not. How am I a helicopter car owner?
You can baby it, take care of it, not anybody touch it. You didn't
well, yeah.
want like people shutting the boot of the car.
That's because you scratched it the fuck up.
I didn't scratch it.
You did.
So needs to be in bed by 9 o'clock.
No, that needs to be out at night. Making me some money. Pink slips.
Demi Papa says, is it wrong I'd go gay for Steve?
No, because I'd go gay for you, motherfucker.
Oh, God. Golfer says his kid's autistic. He has to be a helicopter parent.
No, you don't. No, you don't, because I've already dealt with a helicopter parent.
You said the bad word.
Because I had a parent turn up at my house because their kid was autistic, and my daughter said, you know what? You might be autistic. That's no excuse for you being a dick. Because she uses... Here's the thing. If you're going to let your kids go on the internet and they've got autism, right... And then you're going to fucking start battles with parents when they're being horrible to other kids. And those kids, I've always taught my kids to stand up for themselves. So, you know, if you need to be a helicopter parent for an autistic kid, no, because you're not doing them any favors. Are you going to be fucking there when they're 20 years old? Mm-hmm. Are you still going to be doing that? Are you still going to go, no, you can't say anything. You can't say anything. He's autistic. Believe me, people are going to fucking say things. The same way as when I'm an asshole, people say it to me.
The guy said he's as autistic when he's like, no clue, man, sorry. But, you know, it's like, it's not even just autistic kids. I mean, we're talking about just regular ones, but, you know, do they parent them? Do they still helicopter them at 20? They totally
do. Yeah, they do.
Because, I mean, with my work, I mean, I have people contacting me going, oh, my son needs a resume. And he couldn't email me because...
After Autism Gate happened at the house, right, I sent the parent an email and I said, you are doing her a huge disservice. Because if she genuinely, and I did put this in, if she genuinely has autism, and I don't think she is, I just think she's a cunt, right? But if she genuinely has autism and you are fighting her battles now, when she enters an adult world, she is going to be a fucking useless piece to society. And I know autistic kids. I've got friends who are autistic and they deal with life because guess what? Their parents have fucking let them. They have to take responsibility for their own actions. And this whole, oh, well, they can't help it because they're autistic. I can't help it when I'm drunk.
TV Papa says, okay, Steve, I'm so hard for you right now.
are you stroking that?
You know, and it's like we have a lot of people battle tested, is, you know, it's just saying, you know, these kids, they're just not getting what they need. You know, they're just being babied and it's just...
They're fucking useless, honestly.
They are. The
helicopter parents, and here's the worst part, because all the helicopter parents that should be listening to this show don't. Right? We have not, I mean, you know, I saw Big B, he said he had astronaut parents. and I kind of pretty much, my dad never saw me BMX, never once.
Yeah.
You know that, you know, my, and, oh, did I grow up having a big fucking chip on my shoulder about it? No, it kind of pissed me off at the time, but...
Somebody's saying, you know, freedom and guiding is two totally different things.
Yeah.
And parents just don't seem to get this. And Mason's like, wow, I wish my parents could be watching this right now. And Battletest has said the real world is tough, cruel. We need to prepare them.
Here's the thing, right? We haven't raised Hermione in London, you know, as helicopter kids, right? We've always allowed them to sort out their own problems. I've always let them know that, you know, if it comes...
One second, we'll get to that.
If it's too much for them to deal with, I will step in. Like, the moment an adult comes into the thing, then that's fucking on, right? And she's out of the way, and I will deal with that parent face-to-face. But our kids can deal with shit.
Yeah.
Our kids can actually deal with being rejected. Shock, horror. You know, they can actually deal with that kind of stuff because we haven't just put this fucking hedge around them all day long.
Somebody was saying, could you explain more on your BMX hero days? You mentioned that.
Yeah,
a couple of them. Dean Papa wants to know.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, all right. I'll talk about myself because I don't need
you
an
have
excuse.
One minute
there.
And go.
I have 1 minute. Okay. So, I was BMXing obviously in Britain when it was in the '80s, and I didn't really get to do a lot. Then when I moved to California, I actually ended up going to the Harrow reunion thing, ended up making some friends there, ended up getting invited to Woodward, and so I ended up, for me, I ended up riding with Matt Hoffman, Ron Wilkerson, Dave Norrie, Ryan Nyquist,
we had breakfast with them.
So I spent like a couple years while we were in California, kind of riding with all the BMX greats. Did the mega ramp?
Is damn the big names. Yeah, you've done the mega ramp.
Yeah, did the mega ramp. Yeah, while Hoffman was there, while all the big names were there, and we were all taking turns riding the.
That was the year Hoffman had the very, very, very broken arm.
He couldn't keep
it.
It was his shoulder. He couldn't keep his shoulder in, and he broke his hand. So he duct taped his hand to the handlebar and rode the mega ramp.
Oh, Ginko says his kid goes to Woodward.
So. Oh, cool. Yeah. I mean, okay. Do you go to the East Coast one or the West Coast? So anyway.
The one in China.
The one in China's cool.
They want to know, did you helicopter off the box?
No.
No.
I'm not. Here's the thing. I grew up doing.
It on video. You should post it.
I did flatland freestyle when I was growing up. Oh, okay, cool. All right. So you know the mega ramp there, which is fucking awesome, right? And then, so when I started BMXing again, I was learning to do vert,
which is chappy.
Yeah. So fucking great place. So the old school BMXer reunion. I went to that for quite a few years while we were there. So Ethan came along as well, and you got to meet everybody as well. Yeah. And
So Chad Keggy and.
Yep. Yeah. So all of those. Yeah. It was cool.
I've gone. Mm-hmm. I went the 1 year. Yeah, I just went once, right? Yeah, I just went once.
And Eddie Fiola. He was there.
Eddie Fiola.
Oh, yeah. He's a great guy.
Did you forget his name?
Shit, yeah, I know. Well, to me...
Do you know the name Framey?
No.
No.
No, I don't. But, yeah, for me, meeting Ron Wilkinson was
he's a Scottish guy, you said.
Oh, okay. No, I didn't really know. The only BMXers I knew that were English was, like, Andy Ruffell, and he was a dick to me when I was, like, 14 years old. Because I went to a BMX thing, and he was there, and he basically told me off for breaking one of their, like, brake levers, and I didn't. Mm-hmm. I'm very sore about that still.
Somebody says Steve is the Martin Aprio of England.
Oh, I wish. Okay. No. I can
I'm
look.
Exactly
ground,
sure where that was
ground,
going.
Yeah, no. I mean, ground tricks. You know,
or somebody said he was a twat.
I could be that. So, it's really funny because I don't get intimidated by anybody, and certainly famous people. But meeting all my BMX heroes was interesting.
Like,
I was like a little
ridiculous.
Kid.
Yeah. Did you ever ride with Rob Van Winkle?
No.
No.
I
don't know. So I'm just. I'm reading comments. Not really sure what I'm reading, but.
I didn't really do anything. I didn't ride with any famous people when I was growing up in Britain. Mm. You know, I kind of just did my own thing. I just realized I was very good. So.
No.
Oh yeah, of course it is. Just realized, yeah.
Yeah.
Ugh. But but yeah. No, redoing it again was amazing. That was. I miss riding. I have a very expensive bike in the barn.
Yes, I can verify that.
Yeah. So.
Yes.
And we have two places across the street where you could ride.
I can't ride on there.
It never says no bikes.
It does. I know. I did ask the copper and he said, yeah. He said, they won't let you do that. They said, if they do, he says, I'll get a call. He said, that's what they're like over there.
Oh.
Just do it.
Ginkgo says, no endo will snap the frame.
Oh, I can endo.
Yeah.
I can do the Miami Hopper.
He can
hopper.
Do a lot of shit, actually.
I am
a special friend.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I can do
Cherry
Pickers.
Yeah, he had a custom
yeah,
bike
it wasn't
built.
Strengthened custom. You say it like, oh, he's a fat bastard. He needed, like,
Ginkgo's comment was
iron.
With that
tires
belly.
Are.
Yeah. Steve was doing this when he was still, like, closer to, like, the 400
uh-huh.
mark.
I mean, that's when
was...
I started it. I bought Ethan Dave Mirra bike. Uh-huh. It didn't have any
we
holes
got videos,
in the head.
Real Bridge. We can post them later. Go to the Facebook page.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you can post them later.
No one believed I could actually do tricks, and I did it, and I broke his bike.
No fucking way.
So I had to get the bike... Or I had to get all your wheels straightened out again because I bent it all. So then I bought a Harrow mm-hmm. bike, which was okay, and I liked mm-hmm. that, but it was very heavy. And then when I moved to California, like mm-hmm. the NorCal crew, which if you guys know BMX and you'll know all about the NorCal crew, they were like, let's get you a decent bike. So they helped me build this like really amazing bike. So we did that. It's cool.
So yeah, we got lots of pictures, lots of videos. Yeah, he can actually do all kinds of shit.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of videos of him trying to do stuff in the dark in California. Mm-hmm. Loads of swearing.
Yeah.
Loads of swearing. Yeah.
Trying to
watch it at
work. Well, I was...
not with the sound on anyways.
No, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, lots of fun.
We have people coming back in the room going, oh my God, I hate helicopter parents. Oh my God, what are helicopter parents? So I asked a lot of people, what are their experiences? Mm-hmm. I mean, we have just some of the like younger ones going, oh God, I wish my parents could listen to the show and realize what they are like, but you know.
I think it's up to us adults to start calling helicopter parents out.
My dad brought me to the bully down the street to whip his ass outside.
Fucking A. That, you see, right? Yes. That's exactly what should... See, and this is the thing. And I know the argument, oh, well, violence doesn't solve violence. It does when you're a kid. You need to understand.
Yeah.
Their communication abilities at 10, 11 years old are not there. So, you know...
That's a good idea. Ginkgo says, ship the helicopter parents a bowl of dicks.
Mm-hmm.
We should just get bags of dicks. And
we should, actually.
Helicopter parents. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's... you know, to me, it's... I don't know. It's like, I mean, you know, your dad, Ethan, is a prime example. I mean, you know, this whole thing of, like, taking... oh, you can't watch that because the guidance... you know, label doesn't say you can. And it's like, mm-hmm. but each of you kids are different. You know, it's like, I mean, you know, we have rules in the house. I mean, you know, we won't let Hermione watch scary movies because they actually do affect her.
Mm-hmm.
But London fucking laughs at them. Mm-hmm. So London's watched Annabelle, has no problem at all. She finds it funny.
Yeah.
Hermione watching that film, she got like 5 minutes in, she was like, I'm done.
She's like, I'm going to go upstairs with somebody else.
Yeah, so it's like each, you know, and that's what helicopter parents mm-hmm. definitely don't understand. They don't understand that their kids don't all move along at the same pace.
No.
And that's one of the huge problems that I see.
You know, one person was saying, you know, the problem with helicopter parents is that they all think their kid is like the best thing ever, and they're like completely delusional.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, Mike was saying, you know, his parents just let him take care of business, and it is true. Bullies quit bothering you the moment you beat the shit out of them.
Oh, goodbye to Chicago Fire Department. Thank you, guys.
Hey,
good luck.
Thank you.
Yeah. You guys can do it.
Yeah. Of course they can. Fucking Chicago Fire Department.
Yeah.
Jesus, that's not only a dangerous job normally, but when you're in Chicago.
Chicago.
It's my autism is kicking in. But doing it into Chicago as well, that's like even fucking, because they're dodging bullets as well.
Okay, what world do you live in?
I read it. Chicago's fucking dangerous.
They're like dodging bullets while they're like, you know,
they've had like 500 shootings so
far
this year.
Chicago, not fucking Columbia.
Believe me, Chicago's pretty fucking rough right now. I was watching a random Facebook feed, and there was this woman in Chicago, and I actually heard gunshots, and she barely batted an eyelid, and somebody was writing in the comments, "Oh my god, was that a gunfire?" And she was like, "Yeah, probably." Didn't even bat an eyelid. It's just like, that's how badass those people are there. It's great. I like that. But yeah, so...
Big B says, when he was younger, he took Mortal Kombat over to a friend's house to watch, and his friend's mom made me warn her for all the violent parts so her kids could cover their eyes.
You know...
And you know, parents are still like that.
Yep, they are.
And that's like...
Mm-hmm.
Fuck, it's so annoying.
Yeah.
You know, I get, you know, we probably let our kids watch a lot more than most, you know, but, you know, we also have, like, different, you know, certain kids can only watch certain things.
London Stones.
Aiden could never watch, like, you know, he couldn't play certain video games because he didn't understand the concept of, no, that's not real.
Yeah.
And, you know, so it's like, you know, take every kid for what they are, you know. And
you're a parent. You should know what your kid can and can't deal with. Yeah. Yes.
Ethan's like, I have something to say.
Here we go.
When I was probably about 10,
mm-hmm.
I went over to my next door neighbor's house. He was the same age as I.
Uh-huh.
We were friends. So I went over to his house, just hanging out with him and stuff. We watched Napoleon Dynamite. I loved it. I was 10. It was a great movie. It's still a great movie.
Okay.
I go back over to my house. Uh-huh. I tell my dad that I watched Napoleon Dynamite. And I'm in serious trouble for watching Napoleon Dynamite.
Honestly, I would be angry with you for watching that because I hate that movie with a passion. I know you
but
do.
But that's not why.
No, but that's not. No, that's the thing. I mean, that's the daft thing.
Yeah, Drive by Tweets is like we watched Benny Hill as kids.
Right. Yeah. There we go.
We did.
Yeah.
I mean, you know.
That's fucking awesome. That helped me into the. Hey, he's obviously English. That helped me into the Freeman's catalog.
Yeah,
I'm just going to leave that there. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you know. Robert just like, wow, there were public executions a few years ago. Now we're pussies. You know?
Right, yeah.
And, you know.
You know, here's the weird thing, right? I actually, you know, I don't...
Oh, no, he's in the USA.
Oh, is he? Oh, okay.
Was over here.
Oh, was it? Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. You know, the thing is like, you know, I'm actually not a fan of smacking kids at all. I actually don't think it's right. Mm-hmm. You know, I understand some parents do, and I see the posts all the time of like, oh, well, you know, what this kid needs is a good belt. And I don't really fall into that category only because, you know, your kid, you should be able to, it would be better to explain to them why what they're doing is wrong so they understand. You need to equip them with morals, not, oh, a punishment fits that. And I know I this is where me and a lot of people, you know, part ways on opinions because I'm a total anti-helicopter parent. I mean, I want our kids to be able to stand up for themselves, but when my kids have done things wrong, I want them to understand why.
Yeah.
And I need them to, because generally when kids have done so, I mean, you know, if a kid, I don't know, if a kid breaks a window because he threw a ball through it, I mean, does he really need to get whipped for that? No, it was a fucking stupid mistake, but he needs to understand there's consequences. So you make him work to pay for the window or something like that, you know, and I'm kind of more for that, you know, sort
definitely.
Of side of things. But I'm done with helicopter parents. And
Battle Tessa said helicopter parents create uncoachable kids and uncoachable kids become unemployable adults. And that is
that's interesting.
Truth.
Are you saying that because you're a coach? I'm very interested if he's making, because saying uncoachable, you know, would indicate, oh, you know, because I think it is
for all aspects. It's not just like on a sports aspect, you know, but that's the same thing for whether they're being taught or anything at all.
Oh, it's a nightmare. As an employer, it's an absolute nightmare nowadays because...
Yes, he does coach, he says.
Oh, okay. So you're seeing it firsthand. That's quite interesting. He's saying that they're because I've never heard that. You know, I to me, it follows on logically that they become unemployable. I had to interview some of these people, you know, because helicopter parenting has only really started, kicked off in the late 80s, didn't it?
Oh, I think it's a, fairly new thing. I would say it's probably no more than 10 years old.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But Kate Griss says he likes to punish kids by taking away what they like and making them sit in the room to think about what they did.
Yeah.
After he tells them what they did wrong.
Yeah, again, exactly. That's the thing. I mean, it is that point of they need to understand the consequences.
Yeah, Battletest says, you know, the problem is that, you know, helicopter parents don't let people teach their kids or, you know, be tough on their kids to make them learn or to have respect or whatever, you know.
And that is a thing. I mean, you see, and the helicopter parenting is not working. That's the worst part. It would be something if it worked, but it doesn't.
Yeah,
it makes them worse.
Pepper Stewart also coaches some basketball, and he said kids don't have any respect anymore.
See, now the respect thing, I find that interesting because growing up in Britain, right, kids were mouthy, always mouthy. Mm-hmm. I was considered an extremely polite child, believe it or not. And so I'm very interested of I think the problem with kids and respect is because teachers are actually not allowed to be they're just educators, you know. They can't discipline anymore, and I actually do think I mean would I allow a teacher to hit my kid? No. But if a kid, the way I look at it is that if a kid is misbehaving or talks back, all that teacher's got to do is call me.
Lobeck says he can't stand asshole kids whose parents, you know, just you know, have their back kind of thing. Just,
right.
You know, they stand up for them being assholes.
And that's the thing. It's like, I'll stand up for my kid, but it's like if one of the girls or something like that was being disrespectful to a teacher, believe me, they would prefer the teacher to fucking have a go at them than me, because I will fucking dress them down and make sure, because to me, respect, and I understand the argument, well, it should be earned and this, that, and the other, but you have to at some point employ a default setting to go, they're teaching you. You fucking sit down and you listen.
Yeah, Lobeck said, damn right.
So, I'm just... But I think that all of us that are not helicopter parents need to start calling bullshit.
Yeah, but I'm not giving you the email list. While we've been talking, I actually had another email from another parent. They are coming. And she's like, we might be a bit late because, you know, we're coming directly from,
we're
like,
fucking
sports.
Awesome.
We're coming
there
from
you
our
go.
Sports game. All and she's right. like, and after a full day of school and after hockey, because she's playing field hockey, she's like, we may not be able to stay the whole time, but we're going to do our best.
Fantastic.
Good parent. You know, it's like kids
just
are
put
not
free
be
Coke for the kids, for the adults.
No.
Okay. Damn it.
Drive-By Tweet says kids in England had Cliff Richard. That's why they behaved. Does that mean anything? What does that mean?
Well, Cliff Richard is fucking awful.
Oh. Who is he?
He's a singer. He's like 300 years old. So.
Why would kids behave because of that?
I don't really know.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Kids in Britain, they were mouthy gits. I mean, in Britain, it would be a care. I mean, I used to have it. You know, I see kids hanging around my car or something, and I'd go outside, and I'd be like, go on, off you go. And they go, oh, go fuck yourself, you know. But they'll walk off and do it, but they're mouthing off, right? Yeah. You know, and I mean, you know, as an adult, you just go, okay, fair enough. So you go and find kids that are older than them, and you give them £20, and you say, can you go beat the shit out of those kids and tell them, don't ever fucking stand by my car again? Mm-hmm. Then it works.
Yeah.
You seriously did not listen to what
I
said.
I didn't hear anything you said.
I know that. Let me repeat what I just said. Right? Just so you're aware of what you just agreed with. Ready?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Uh-huh. I'm just reading people's comments at the same time. I don't listen to half of the things you say. I have to interject tweets.
I was just loved it the way she just very calmly. I said that when, you know, in England, like if kids were hanging around my car or something, I'd go outside and I'd go on, off you go. And they'd be like, yeah, all right, go fuck yourself. And they'd walk off. And then I would go find kids that are bigger than them, pay them £20 to go beat up those kids and tell them Steve said don't ever buy his fucking car again.
I believe you did that.
Yeah, I did.
I did that. I believe
no,
that
actually,
100%.
No, the best part ever was I had some kids.
Astral Bridge.
I had some kids actually break a window on my van once. I had a van and they bust the window and they tried to...
likes it.
So I paid two kids £50 to find out who did it.
Shit, that's a lot of money.
Holy shit, they were fucking better than the police, because the police had no idea. Police had no fucking idea. Those kids, in 20 minutes, right, not only had got who it was, that they actually had got them to come to my house. And then I said to the police, there you go, there they are. And so the police went over there and the parents actually paid for my window and I gave the kids 50 quid out of that. See? Reward. But you know that the kids that smash that window next time are going to be like, fuck, I better not do this. But that's the thing nowadays. Kids think they can get away with murder.
And
they can't. Yay!
That was quick.
Yeah, what was it? Just a cat, was it?
Well, it was just one of them, so maybe like the rest of them went, but he stayed back.
Yeah, you'll see some pussy up a tree, is that what it is? You'd be like, yeah, I'm just going to stand here and watch it. Mm-mm. No, why don't you turn around? I'm sure they don't do that.
I'm pretty sure they don't. So.
They do.
What?
Oh, what shit, maybe only one of them came back.
I don't think they'd be back that quickly.
Okay.
Yeah, right. And a vet's saying, you know, kids actually rule their parents today.
Mm-hmm.
And that's totally, totally true. And
I've seen...
Kids, like, piss me off.
I've seen kids...
You have friends that do that. That, like, totally rule their parents.
Yeah.
Or, like, did you know kids that were like that?
Yeah, but I also
imagine
know...
Imagine at your high school that was very much the case, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
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 The problem is that those kids are running through life thinking they're untouchable. And when you get into the workplace now, of course, if you punch somebody in the workplace, you get sued. So again, they become untouchable. Mm-hmm. And they start to move through life.
Mm-hmm.
And it is because we've created this society where you can't actually execute justice properly. And you do need a certain amount of social justice mm-hmm. to happen immediately. So when a kid's being a dick, he needs to be checked. Yeah. Hard, really hard.
But they're not, you know.
No.
Real Bridge says he hates the parents the same. I'm going to count to three and then they only get to two.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But, you know, a lot of people are just saying, you know, that, you know, based on the whole, you know, thing of, you know, kids ruling their parents nowadays, you know, a lot of people are saying, oh, yeah, you know, my fiance's, you know, son is just like pure evil mm-hmm. and, you know. Yeah, I mean,
you
have that. And I really... It's frustrating as another parent because you can't actually say anything to the other parent for make them mm-hmm. realize that. You know, it's just going to cause more problems, but they're not going to do anything about it.
Right.
And it's just going to cause a problem for you, but it's not going
right.
to change
Stephanie.
The situation.
Yeah.
Stephanie.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have speaker up.
You don't.
No.
But that is, I watch it. We had a situation here where Hermione was, you know, friends with another girl locally. And just in case the parents are listening, it's not Kylie. Kylie's fucking awesome. She's the best kid ever. I'm on about the other one. And if the other one's listening, yes, your kids are shit. Right? And her kid literally fucking rules not only her mum, but her aunt as well. And this is what she does. She just wears them down.
Mm-hmm.
And she tried it here. It was like I said no to something, and she just asked me again. I was like, "Are you deaf or stupid?" And she looked horrified.
She actually said that I was
yeah,
there.
Wow. I did. Yeah. And she was like, "Oh, sorry." I was like, "That's fine." Said I've said no. That's the end of it. But I noticed, and this was the problem. We stopped mm-hmm. Hermione playing with her because Hermione was adopting the same thing. She would do this like, "Well, can I do this?" No. Why? I'm not going to explain this now. You're not doing that. Okay, can I do this? I've already said no. And I'm like, my blood boils after the second time I get asked. You know, kids have got to know. And that's what I do see. Kids are starting to... We knew it as kids. Mm-hmm. You could ask one parent. You'd play one parent against the other. But what happened to us as kids when we did that? We got fucking in trouble. But nowadays, it doesn't happen. You know, it's just like, oh, mum said no, I'll go ask dad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then it's like, well, dad said I could. You know, and bullshit like that. But... Me as a kid, when I used to pull that shit, holy fuck, the whole earth fell down in front of me.
I didn't ever ask my dad anything because he didn't have any answers. He just said, ask your mother, whatever
yeah,
she says
I mean,
goes.
That, you know, and that's the way to do it, really. I think that is the way that you need one parent that just makes the decision.
See, like, as a kid, I was a smart enough kid to go, if I ask my mom this, is she actually mm-hmm. going to let me do this? And
right.
I'm not going to bother asking if I didn't think she was going to let me.
Right.
You know, like mm-hmm. Hermione keeps asking the one thing. You know, oh, mm-hmm. can I go play with this friend? No.
That's
you
it.
Can keep asking me all you want, and it's mm-hmm. not happening. It's not going to happen. And, you know, I think kids just don't have that realization anymore.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it is definitely... yes, it's tricky. Yes, mm-hmm. Stephanie said that you know, her little one is an angel elsewhere, but a demon at home. Mm-hmm. Usually just when I come around. She probably knows you're worn out. I mean, I'll tell you, she's got you clocked way
she's
more than you
that
realize.
Bad. I've heard so. Her on Skype.
Oh, she sounds really fucking annoying. I would hate her in London together. They would just be, ugh. Yeah. No, I like that she's in Texas and we're up here. I like them being friends at that distance. Because London can be annoying as fuck as well, just so we're clear.
Well, yeah.
I'm very realist about my kids. I could tell you all the bad points of my kids.
Yeah, we know. You've probably said all of them on the show here.
I've said all of them to their faces as well.
Yes. Very true. Mm-hmm.
You know, because I want kids... Because to me, it's like... I think it's important as an individual that you understand what your problems are. So it's like, you know, for Hermione, because she's a fucking drama queen, right? She needs to understand that Hermione, you make a complete crisis out of nothing. You need to understand that when you're in the real world, right, when you're working at a job or you're dealing with somebody, we're not going to have somebody that's going to be interested in your fucking drama. So I'm going to practice it now.
Steve just came on.
Hey, Steve. Best name in the world.
Best name in the world. He said, I don't understand what's a helicopter parent.
Helicopter parents are, are parents that basically do... everything for their kids. So they make sure their kids don't have any. Well, they don't allow their kids to have outward stresses. The reality is that they're massively stressed inside.
Now, if that says she's a helicopter parent, strict, yet, you know, she's also like, lets them do stuff. She's like, you know,
then you're
not
helicopter.
Unreasonable. So, you know, that's not the same thing.
I'm not on about strict parent. I'm not on about you can't do that. That's not helicopter. The helicopter parent is the one that goes, you know, that. How do I explain that properly? Okay, so like if there's a... When kids have a falling out at school, the parent is fucking in there like a bolt of lightning to sort it out for the kid.
Yeah.
And they'll deal with the kid. We've had it happen here where parents have tried to fucking talk to my girl. Oh, you're on a fucking hiding to nothing then. You know, I mean, that kind of bullshit. Helicopter parenting is just arranging everything. Over control, there's a difference between being strict... And being controlling. Controlling would be you're not allowed to spend a penny without reconciling it. You can't have a phone unless you check in every 30 minutes. Parents, if your kids have phones and you tell them to check in every hour, you're a helicopter parent. And don't give me bullshit. Well, they might get abducted. Abduction is fucking lower now than it ever has been in the fucking 80s when nobody even had a fucking pager. So stop making that as an excuse and just use geotagging like the rest of us.
I love it, said you are right on.
Yeah, brother.
And Steph said, yes, Emmy has got her all figured out.
Then unfigure it. Give yourself a break.
Change
because
it up. Confuse her.
Sit her down. Look at her direct in the eye. I always find, right, at about a 6 or 8 inch elevation to their eyes, so they're understanding that they're looking up at you because that involves more fear. You look directly down at them and go, I know what you do and you need to cut it out. And when they go, I don't know what you mean, and they play all this, well, I'm just 7, I don't know what you mean. You go, you do.
Somebody said,
cut it
would
out.
You let your kid go out in Brixton all alone? Like without checking in?
Mm-hmm. No, okay, there's a different... Okay, there's... All right, if we're... Dude, if you're on about fucking Brixton or you're on about, like, I mean, Christ, I mean, fucking, I don't know, fucking Clifton in Bristol or Newport, there's a certain... If you're allowing your kid to go out, right, and they are not responsible enough to handle themselves, you probably shouldn't let them out that much. You know, again, treat them. I got fucking beaten up as a kid when I went out. I went down too far. I went further than I should. There was a whole bunch of kids. I had my fucking head kicked in. Guess what happened? I didn't go down there anymore. Thus, I learned. I could have done it the easy way and listened to my parents, but I was a kid and I knew better. So I did it my way. And I learned the hard way. So, you know, Brixton isn't that bad, actually. It's not as bad as people make out. It's bad, but...
Maybe it's worse now.
No, it's not.
You haven't been there for a long
I know.
Time.
It's all full of, what are they called? Road men?
Angel Town?
I don't know. I don't know Brixton enough for that. I just know. St. Paul's in Bristol probably is a prime example. And let's just call, you know, what we're saying here. It's generally more black community and it's very, very poor. And for some reason, everybody then associates that with fucking violence. And what I found, I don't know about it over here, but I know in Britain, the violence only happened if you moved in those circles. Mm-hmm. Very few innocent people, like, get, you know, fucking mugged and this, that, and the other. Most, I mean, I get general mugging or whatever, but when you're on those kind of estates, you kind of know which areas to move and which ones are not. So, but yeah.
Steph said her daughter is really good, but so super emotional, and she's not. So basically, she tells her to shut up.
There you go.
Shut that bullshit crying.
There you go. That's the way you need to do it. Here's the thing. It's like, you know, Hermione's like that. You know, the moment, all I've got to say to Hermione is go, I'm actually disappointed in you. And it's like that. You know, and to me, it's like, that ain't going to work. And I've said that. You know, your crying is not going to make me change my mind. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I mean, you know, you've got to be... Kids, you remember us as kids. We were all fucking testing our parents. And guess what? Our parents never fucking gave in. Mm-hmm. You are not a bad parent for not giving in. You're actually a better parent for standing your ground and going, no, I fucking said no, that's it. Right? If you ask me again, whatever's going to happen is going to get elongated even longer.
Steve says, are these the kind of parents that say, oh, your child finished last, but here's a trophy anyway?
Oh, yes. Fuck yes.
Yes.
Oh, my God, parent. Yes.
Yes.
Everybody's a winner. You wait and see if that flies in fucking corporate. No, I couldn't be bothered to turn up today. Oh, that's okay. You'll still get paid. Doesn't happen. And I don't understand why parents force this issue. They force it of like... Well, you know, I think all kids... schools are terrible for this now. Mm-hmm. They're like, you know, the grading system is so fucking confusing. It used to be easy. If you're an A student, you were smart. If you're a D student, you're fucking stupid. Mm-hmm. We knew where we all stood. I knew I was fucking stupid at school. Did I have a crisis about it? No. I didn't give a fuck. It was school. I'm a kid. I don't like school. The A students liked school because they were suck-up assholes and just basically shitty people all round. But nowadays, it's like, oh, no, you know, it's like everybody's got to try and, you know, we've got to, oh, well, they're not for it. Where was it? Oh, was it California? No, it was Texas. Texas had this weird fucking thing of, like, if a kid is really fucking stupid, but they're good in something else, when you go and speak to the teacher, they do the sandwich thing. They talk about a good thing, mention the bad thing quickly, go back to a good thing. And all I'm caring about, when I go and see a teacher, I want to know where my kid's fucking up. I don't give a rat's ass how good they're doing. Because it's fucking school, it's useless, they're not learning jack shit. Mm-hmm. So all I want to know is what's going wrong with the kid. Tell me that. And having a teacher now, they're scared to tell us. They're actually, well, yeah, you know, her, she's not quite there on the average. Right, she's not even fucking average, so she's fucking retarded. Is that what you're telling me? Well, no. She's just not quite at the standards. Right, you tell me what I need to do to get that standard where it needs to be.
Yeah, Steph said, you know, Mark is working with the soccer association. Every kid gets a trophy. She said it's ridiculous.
Yeah. See, now Marcus could make a change there, because when he's handing out the trophies to the losing team, just go, you're a loser. You're a loser. You're a loser. This is a trophy for being a loser.
He doesn't do that.
I bet you he does. I bet you there's days when he's just gone.
No, it's not a teacher's job to raise the kid. That's exactly...
Oh, no. You know, I'm not saying that.
No. You know, they just need to they need to stop being scared of talking
but
to parents.
I want to... No, yeah. My issue with teachers is that it is that thing of like, well, you can't do anything with the kids. Mm-hmm. The kids are with you a lot of the day. You should be allowed to fucking... discipline those kids when needed. Mm-hmm. You know, and you know, this I don't know, you know, I've met career teachers already here, and they are the worst fucking example of human beings ever, because they are there to do a fucking job.
Not even just
that's
the
all
teachers,
they care.
Of all human beings.
They are the worst. Okay. They are like Hitler, right? Hitler did his job, right? He just killed Jews, right? A career teacher, that's all she's doing. She's going in there just to fucking pass a test so she can get her fucking pension at the end of the day. Not interested with you. Go fucking kill yourself. That's what you need to do. But I've also met teachers here who genuinely love to educate kids. Mm-hmm. And those teachers, I will throw 100% of my support behind. Mm-hmm. You know, and we had Hermione's teacher in fifth grade wasn't necessarily the most socially apt at dealing with a classroom of kids, and she was having a problem because one of Hermione's friends was very boisterous, Mm-hmm. And but she felt comfortable enough with us to go, I've kind of got a problem, right? Hermione's friend, you know, kind of gets the whole class in fits of laughter and it's really unruly. And kind of Hermione joins in as well. And I'm like, leave it to me. Me and Hermione, 10 minutes, sat down. I was like, you have a responsibility. And you know, and it fixed the problem. You know, so, I understand teachers have got a shit job nowadays. However, right? Just as an average here, how many teachers did I deal with in Texas? Three? Three in Texas.
Three and a headmaster.
Three and a headmaster. Okay. All of those teachers in Texas were fucking useless and the headmaster should be fucking shot. Not even delete your Twitter account, headmaster. No, literally, put a gun to your head, pull the trigger. You are a waste of space, right? California, okay? First couple teachers, great. The last teacher she had before she went, fucking useless. I don't know what the fuck she was, how she passed even a basic fucking intelligence test is beyond me. Totally useless, right? We've come to Maine. Hermione's teacher, fucking great, last year, mm-hmm. right? London's teacher last year, fucking useless. Everybody loves her. Everybody loves her. You know why? Because she's just this happy, jolly person. Fucking useless, though.
A vet's going, oh, my kids go to private school. Well, I think it doesn't make a difference whether it's private or public.
Actually, I'll be honest. I am totally against private schools. Mm. I'm complete because it is already building into the system, right, that money, right, allows you to Mm-hmm. You can take two kids and you put one of them through the public system and one through the private. And in theory, mm-hmm. private will elevate faster. Mm-hmm. But you have shitty teachers in private school as well. I went to a private school and I know how fucking bad they can be. If you think you're getting top-notch education, think again. They fudge fucking results. Mm-hmm. I know that for a fact. Yeah, they're just whatever.
Somebody said, Steve, please tell us how you really feel.
Oh, really? You want to hear how I really feel?
He's joking.
Right.
He's joking.
1945.
Yeah, Robridge, my parents, he said, try Catholic school. Yeah, my parents wanted me to go to that. And I was like, no.
It's, you know, private schools have their own problems because the problem with private schools is, of course, they can pretty much pick their curriculum.
So, Merrick says he went to private school because he was a fuck up.
He went to a private school because he was a fuck-up. Mm-hmm.
And Robridge went to his Catholic school for 7 years.
Right. So, I mean, yeah, if you get sent there because you get kicked out of regular school, that's kind of funny, really. That, you know, it's like, yeah. For punishment, like, yes. We're going to give you a better education. all right. It is all fucked up. Look, yes. You know, and I don't want to get on the subject of schools and stuff, but, I mean, education needs to be scrapped and rebuilt because it's completely mm-hmm. dated and it's fucking useless and, you know, just in life you don't take fucking exams. Why the fuck are you taking them during school all the time? There is no point. You need to let kids learn and be creative and learn and fucking let kids be wrong. Stop punishing them when they get something wrong. It's fucking insane. It's like, how the fuck do you think we built everything around here? You think somebody built the fucking space shuttle straight off first time? Look at Elon Musk. He can't even build a fucking rocket nowadays.
Mike says he works hard so he can send his kids to private school. Other people say you can learn more life skills in regular school.
You don't learn.
Common Core is going to make a generation of idiots.
Okay, yes. I
went to Catholic school for 4 years too.
The education system, even in private schools, is broken. It's dated.
But you weren't going to talk about education.
I'm not going to talk about that.
Okay.
No, Miguel, I don't have Skype up. I did, and then we've started shifting stuff again, and we're just, mm-hmm. you know. Constantly trying to downsize.
Real Bridges, he just works hard to give his dogs a better life.
His dogs. All right. Excellent. They're probably a lot less hassle.
So now everybody that's listening realizes why I'm not going to give my email address of parents to
you
Steve.
Should give I'm me not. Fucking parents.
I like Ethan's idea. Give it to him before we leave.
Yeah.
Like a few days before we leave Maine. You can have it.
I'm at that point in my life where I see bullshit. I'm starting to call bullshit because it is. It's just. I know we joke about. No, this is something different.
He's getting an old grumpy bastard.
We joke about it on the show of like, oh, you need to tell those fuckers where it is. But I really am at that stage. I mean, it was like, you know, when the person, when you have somebody, right, taking orders and making sandwiches who can't A, fucking take orders and B, make sandwiches. right? As a human being, it is your job to tell that person they can't fucking do their job. Mm-hmm. And I felt guilty when I did it. And then the more I thought about it, I was like, no, you know what? I was right. And we do. We need to start telling. We need to start telling people when they're being just bullshit. And calling them on it. And don't, you don't have to.
You
here's the thing.
Finish.
What?
Go ahead, finish. Mm-hmm.
But here's the thing. You don't actually have to, like, actually call them. You don't have to be tactful. You don't have to go, mm-hmm. Oh, you know, I would really, you know, I think I want to talk to you about this. We got a parent right now, right? There's a parent right now. He clearly has no fucking clue. His daughter is on Instagram, right? Mm-hmm. She's 10 years old. She's talking about fucking killing herself and all this other shit. And that dopey fucker is sat there still fucking wallowing in his own self-pity. Now, I know every fucking parent is like, well, maybe, I don't know if we should say something. We shouldn't get involved. Me, I gotta fucking go say something.
That's why I said he looked like Andrew Zimmern.
God damn it.
If you'd like to give somebody your thoughts, Big B wants to know your thought on the Segway Mini Pro.
What the fuck is a Segway Mini Pro?
It's like one of those, like, the hoverboard things that you hate.
Like, I hate all Segways. Version. I hate all of those things.
Well, no. You know the ones with the wheels that you stand on and you lean forward?
Oh, yeah.
Those ones, but it's like that, but it has, like, two things that go up, I think.
You oh, yeah.
Them with your leg? I don't know. Mm-hmm.
I saw a hilarious one. It's on a pole. It has a dildo. And there's a woman walking around and it's doing that.
I don't think that's what he's talking about.
Oh, okay. Okay, that I'm all for. That I'm all for, because honestly, most women need to chill the fuck out a bit more.
Robert says he loves his hoverboard.
Mm. I think hoverboards are cool. I just don't like Segways. Segways
like
are
that?
Just...
Mm.
No, I think hoverboards are fun, because here's the thing. I have yet to see a fat person on a hoverboard. They're all kind of kids and they're kind of messing around. But who do you always see on fucking Segways? Fat fuckers who need to get... It's the same as invalid carts. There's no fucking invalids on invalid cars anymore. It's just fat bastards. When was the last time you saw a thin
invalids.
Person... No, they're not.
I know.
They're not an invalid. They're fucking fat. There's a difference. They're not an invalid.
They're not
fucking disabled.
I know. You don't have to
when
like
was the last time you saw a thin person on a fucking a little electric cart? You don't. You see those fuckers with their 14 walking sticks trying to hobble around still.
It's weird because some growing up, nobody ever used those. They
I know
were just always there. Now
see,
they're
no
all
shame.
Used.
No
now
fucking
they're
shame.
All used in the store.
Mm-hmm. No fucking shame anymore. No, and that's it. I've seen grown men, right? Mm-hmm. I've seen... It was like... What was it? He was like, you're fucking... I swear to God, I nearly fucking kicked the thing out from underneath him. He was like 19, right? He was on one of those little... fucking retarded scooters when you break your leg. You know, you like bend your leg, so you rest your leg on that, and it was in like... He was on that, and it had like a little steering wheel, and he was pushing along.
Wait, who?
Oh, some kid I saw in Freeport. I swear to God, I was like, I need to kick that out from him. I need to man the fuck up. Seriously, get a fucking crutch, not a crotch. He probably hasn't got one. Fucking man up. Good God alive.
One of our new listeners who's also asked you about Brixton wants to know what you think about Brexit.
Oh, I think Britain should never have left. That was the stupidest fucking move ever. Fucking that right there.
Find your old show on that. Listen that, to it.
That
You'll
right
it.
There shows how fucking stupid Britain people who voted for that are. Because everything, the reason you voted for it doesn't fucking exist. And it's not going to be fixed by leaving it.
Somebody says you look like a young Alexei Sale.
I'll take that. I like Alexei Sale. He's all right, he is.
Okay.
Oh, really?
You look more like Andrew Zimmern. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, Alexei Sale, he's funny as fuck he was. So... I know, Big B, I'm the same as you. I see those carts. I just, you know, it's, I got, and here's how I know it's getting beyond a joke with me now. Because we were in Hannaford's the other day, right? And guess what? Invalid cart. Guess who was sat in it? What was it? A thin disabled person? No, it was just a fat fucker. And his entire fucking case, right, was soda, fucking chocolate, fucking cakes, all of this. And I honestly, I could feel the rage inside me because I wanted to actually just go... That's your problem. Go put it back. Go eat a fucking salad. This is why you can't fucking walk anywhere. And I think we should. This whole thing of like fucking, oh, you shouldn't fat shame people. You fucking need to. You really fucking need
so
to.
It's just like helicopter shaming.
My doctor. Yeah, it is actually. Mm-hmm. My doctor in California was the one who fucking woke me up mm-hmm. to it. Because she turned around to me and she was like, Steve, you're a fat fucker. And if you don't change what you're going to do, you are not even going to see your kids graduate. Mm-hmm. That was the fucking wake up call I needed. And it's fucking hard losing weight. I'm trying, but it's fucking difficult. But at least I'm doing something about it. Those fat fucks, when they're fucking in the grocery store, oh, I'm going to get another six pack of fucking Pepsi. We need to go up to them and go, put it back. You're a fucking tard. Put it back and go get some water. Oh, it's glandular. Glandular, my ass. Bend over. I'll show you how fucking glandular it is.
I found one of those hoverboard things for just $120.
Does it blow up? Is it like a Samsung Galaxy?
No, but...
Oh, by the way, can I just make
it... We can get it and see how well or how poorly he does on it.
I would do it. Oh, yeah, I'd fucking use it. Yeah,
you can break stuff.
I know.
Like, yourself. Well,
but it only... The maximum payload is only 100 kilograms and...
Oh, I'm only 109, so I found out. No, I'm not. I'm 116. I'm 116 kilograms
well,
100 now. 100
kilograms is like 220 or something.
Yeah, I know. I'm
like
I'm over it a lot. I'm 250 something or other. Batteries are turning up tomorrow for the scale, so I'll know.
Oh, is it out?
Yeah. No. Yeah, quick thing, just so everybody's completely aware, right?
Mm-hmm. And Miguel has a gland for you.
Yeah. just a quick thing. Obviously, Samsung is, you know, have got all these Note 7s blowing up, right? And fuck you, Miguel. I hate you with a passion. And I didn't even have to look. I just could see out of the corner of my eye he typed a three-digit number. And Samsung said, if you don't bring the Note in to like get it swapped or whatever's going on, they will deactivate it. So, and everybody's like, oh, wow. Think about that. Samsung have access to your phone globally to deactivate it. Now, if you can deactivate it, I can tell you right now, they can fucking turn on cameras. They can turn on things on a global scale. This is a company that is not regulated by any privacy rules. So I just want everybody to be aware. That you're
like, what, really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just want everybody to be aware that it doesn't matter what phone you buy, there is always, always a backdoor into that system. And your privacy has went fucking before the cell phone even turned up. Sorry, I'm just...
He says he's going to go back to the Nokia 3310.
Fuck yeah.
Are those the little like chunky ones that are like
yeah.
the size?
Yeah, they're like the kind of the yeah. kind of like that size. Mm-hmm. And they had the...
They're like a coffin.
Yes, they do, yes. Yeah.
Those ones.
And seriously, you could be buried in one because it would last that well.
Yes, it would.
Just the most amazing phones ever. So,
drop
yeah.
it, get it wet, it's totally fine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Run over it with a car by accident a little bit, still
yeah,
works.
Yeah, I mean, even the old Motorola Flip, not the Razr, I'm on about the black bugger that was like way before, real chunky bastard. You could drop that all day long. Nothing ever broke. Mm-hmm. But anyway, I wanted to just make that point with the Samsung Note. Bigby, I applaud you for not having a phone. It's, yes. So,
yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So how much was the hoverboard?
It's like 120, mm-hmm. it seems.
120?
Some random site.
I could buy it.
Stix says his iPhone's going to the bin.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah. It's a good
choice. Yeah, I well, here's the thing. Bigby said, you know, the government is watching us. No, my honest, and this is total openness of Steve now. I don't care about the government watching me. That's not the point. It's all these companies that are not fucking regulated by any. We have controls in place to prevent government. We have checks that go on. That's why, you know, we have things like Edward Snowden that came out that kind of blew the lid off all of that. These corporates, they don't have anybody to answer to. They answer to their shareholders. So, you know, and we know, we've tested this so many times. When we have our phones on, our ads basically start showing what we talk about, especially on this show.
Mm-hmm.
My Facebook, like, side panel after talking on this show is really fucked up. And there's some mm-hmm. advertiser going, oh, my God, they're talking about double-ended dildos for elephants. Fuck yeah, I can now sell it. Woo! And it's, yeah, it's like that. So it is, it's, you know. And here, God, I so didn't. Jesus, why am I doing this as well? And just to take it just a little bit further, I actually don't have a problem with any corporates listening, because I would prefer. The internet isn't free, however much we like to kid ourselves, and apps and everything else, trying to explain that to Noah was a joke. The apps, you know, they're free for a reason, because they look at your habits. I would prefer advertisers to give me adverts that are more relevant to me. So at the end of the day, I'm totally for adverts. I would prefer to see shit that's actually relevant to me. So if they want to listen in on everything I say, that's fine. The problem I have with that is whether or not at any point that data can be used. Like, as an example, nowadays you can post something on Facebook and get arrested for it. You see, and that to me is where the problem lies with all of this social stuff and all this internet stuff.
Somebody said elephant-sized dildos. Good luck with that, Steve. No, we know where to find them.
Yeah, we do. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep.
So, yes, I definitely want to go see this Snowden movie, because I have a bit of a boy crush on Joseph Lovett Hewitt, or whatever his name is.
What? Oh,
the guy who plays Snowden. Yeah. Oh.
Did you hear him?
Yeah, there's just something about him. He's a bit of a cuddle waddle, isn't he? Kind of just want to give him a cuddle waddle. Yeah.
Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
Yeah, 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 yeah. He has, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. He's just funny. He's, you know, he's like, oh.
Oh my god.
Like, if the apocalypse happened, I would make him my bitch.
Would you?
Yeah, in the same way Danny McBride did to Magic Taylor. Mike. There you go. Yeah, I would do the same way with that.
Okay. And done. Just leave it at that for the day.
Yeah, I can't top
making
that.
Joseph Gordon-Levitt his bitch. And during the apocalypse. Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's right. Stop, and the apocalypse is going to happen if we don't stop helicopter parents. Follow Jane on Periscope, obviously, because if you don't, you're not with the cool kids, and all the cool kids smoke.
No, I didn't even spike his coffee this morning.
Nope, nothing at all.
This is just pure ridiculousness from parents. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And you know who you are.
Yeah.
All right.
And Harpswell Radio, if you are listening, yes, that was about Harpswell people, and yes, they do really fucking annoy me.
Mwah. You're still going to give us the show?
No, I doubt
it. I don't think so.
No, he's a cool guy, actually. I think he'd be pretty cool with all this. I got to email him, actually.
Yes, but
just think about
really
it, people.
Want people showing up, like, you know, with, like, you know.
I do. We'll go live.
Forks.
We'll just go live immediately. I'll just be like, look.
Make
look,
sure to follow.
There's a group of 30 people out here, and collectively the IQ is still under 100. Isn't that awesome?
Follow me on Periscope, because in case that happens, you will want to watch that. hello in the UK, we're done with the show, so
hey
watch
guys,
the replay.
Thanks for turning up late.
Yeah. They probably were having dinner.
Probably.
Yeah. At John's. Okay. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
Yes, we will.
Yes.
What's tomorrow? Wednesday. Oh, I get my show tomorrow.
Yes.
What?
No. I don't know.
Oh, you won't be.
No.
No,
because
you're...
Yes, I do, because it's at 2.
Oh, so we can do the show.
Yeah, we'll do a show tomorrow. Okay. But then, from Wednesday onwards, no show. No Wednesday shows.
Cool.
Okay. See you guys tomorrow. The UK guy said at least we turned up. That
yeah,
was the point.
This is
watch
true.
Watch the replay.
This is true.
And we'll see everybody
tomorrow. You're now an accessory to rape. Bye.